Hello everyone, and welcome to Connect with Uganda. My name is Ray. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. If you are a new subscriber, you're very welcome. If you are a returning subscriber, I thank you so much for returning. And if you have not yet subscribed, make sure that you do subscribe. Tap on the bell so that you don't miss any uploads. So today I'm going to tell you five things that you must do before you travel to Africa. These are a must five things you must do before you travel to Africa. So point number one is health and safety. We know the current situation with COVID. Make sure that you do your research about the country that you're going to, know what they do require for you in terms of that, because it varies from each and every country. Some countries are open, some are not. In addition to that, make sure that you do get your yellow fever card. Most African countries are going to ask for that. You need to be vaccinated for yellow fever. Be aware of things like malaria. Be aware of tropical insects just hanging around, you know, like mosquitoes, anything, because Africa in general is very, very warm. So you have all these little insects running around. So you might want to carry a mosquito or insect repellent, because if you are not used to these bugs, they can really irritate you. So health and safety is very, very important. In addition to this, be aware of dust. You know, in a country like Uganda, the roads are not in the best conditions. There is potholes, they're not fully tarmacked, some are just maram roads. So be dust flying everywhere. You're likely to get allergies, you're likely to get flu, you're likely to get irritated. So just be aware of these little things. Even when it comes to like water for bathing, you might want to carry something like to put in your water. Just make sure that your skin doesn't get irritated. So be aware of all these little things when it comes to your health and your safety. And of course, for the clothing, for a general advice is that just wear clothing that is long sleeved and also very, very light, because most African countries are just warm. There is no winter. But of course, this depends on the country that you're going to. Point number two is carry enough cash on you, preferably in US dollars. US dollars are recognized everywhere in the world. Even if you went to a village in Africa, at least everyone knows a US dollar. The dollar is not a Canadian dollar or a Jamaican dollar. If you say dollar, it's the US dollar. So it's best to have US dollars on you and have enough. Reason being, you are going to go to some places within Africa and you find that the ATM machine available is just a local one, it's not international, especially if you move away from the cities and maybe you want to go into the villages and maybe do a safari and tour. Most of these areas, they might not have your visa ATM machine that is going to recognize your international visa card. So it's best to have enough cash on you. And secondly, I have seen this in my country, Uganda, and I believe in other countries as well. There is a limit to how much money you can take out of the ATM machine, even if you are in a city like Kampala. So the ATM machine in Uganda is going to give you about 1,000,000 shillings per day. That's about maybe like $285. And you find that's all you can get for a day. So imagine if you are in a situation where you need maybe $1,000 or $2,000, you're going to become limited on how much money you can have, yet you actually do have money on your account, you know. In relation to this point, I would also advise that talk to your bank before you travel to Africa. You know, ask them, I'm going to Africa, what is the best way that I can get money to myself while I'm there? And they can advise you, especially if you want to do like international wire transfers of money. Then you want to know, how do you go about that procedure? What kind of things are you going to need, especially if you want to maybe open a local bank account, if you're trying to do a business in a certain African country. So you want to be aware of those requirements before you actually travel, so that you know, if I go to Uganda or Nigeria, this is how I'm going to transfer money for myself. If I want to transfer to myself $10,000, then it's cheaper to do a wire transfer than do Western Union or MoneyGram. So it's best to talk to your bank, from what I've seen, before you come, so that you are aware of these procedures. In addition to that, you should also be aware that most of the popular ways of transferring money, like a Cash App. I know Cash App is very popular in the US. They do not work in most African countries, but things like Western Union, MoneyGram, which have been existing for very many years, those work in most of the countries. Point number three is book a local guide to assist you on your travel. If you are going to a new country, it is best advisable to get in touch with a local person to assist you, you know, because local people are going to tell you things that you won't find on the internet, things that you won't find on Google, things that you won't find on YouTube. You know, they're going to be able to tell you these things. So make sure that you have this person maybe to show you around the town, show you how you got your local public means of transport, show you how you get your SIM card, you know, show you the best place to go and find some good food, the best place to go and find maybe even a decent place to stay that is affordable and cheapable. So at least for 2 or 3 days, you know, make sure that you have someone local to help you out. And then of course, if you're very adventurous, after you've gotten your way around, then you can see, okay, let me dive into deep and do this on my own, you know. So that's why I come in as a channel, because this channel is all about helping you out. If you want to visit Uganda for your first time, if you want to relocate to Uganda, if you want to start a business in Uganda, this is the place for you to come to. There is an email in my description box. There is even a link to our website that describes all that we do on this channel. So reach out to me. I'll be glad to help you in any of those areas. So it is very, very important to have a local person to guide you, especially if it is your first time visiting a particular country. Point number four is come with an open mind. Whichever country you're coming from, whatever you have in your mind, whatever expectations or life that you're used to, just leave it behind when you're coming to Africa. Know you're coming to a whole different experience and whole different situation here. So electricity might black out, and that is going to surprise you. That happens here all the time. Water might disappear. Yes, that might happen. You're going to travel in a car, and the car is very old, very cracked on the road, especially if it's public means of transport. The roads are going to be very bumpy and very dusty. If you're used to the nice, smooth roads at home, you might not be able to find this here. People are even going to stare at you. When people see someone that is different from them, of course, it is going to be very, very easy to identify whether you're white, whether you're black, whether you're Asian. It is very easy to identify, like the way you talk, you know, the way you move around, the way you dress. People can easily tell this person is not from here, this person is from here. So they'll give you that curiosity look, and don't take it offensively. Just say hello, give a smile, be nice, be kind. So just come with an open mind to all these things. For the most part, Africans are very, very respectful people, you know, most of the times, and very, very friendly as well. I've had stories where people go to Europe or America and they tell me, oh my God, those people are so mean, everyone minds their business, no one cares. It's the complete opposite here. People are just curious, people might just want to know about your business. Just be polite, be kind, say no in a good way, don't be offensive. So just come with an open mind. Some things will not make sense to you, some things will make sense to you. So be open. It's just how it is. Point number five is respect the laws and the traditions of the country that you're coming to. So it is very, very important to know the laws of a certain country, the norms, the traditions, and the customs before you go to that country, because honestly, you don't want to get in trouble with the authority when you are in a different country. You don't want to get in trouble with people just because of a small little argument, you know, because you have a different mindset. They have a different mindset, you have a different perspective of things, they have a different perspective of things. So something very, very tiny might cause an argument among two different people, just because you all have different ways of looking at life and looking at things. So just be respectful. I've already mentioned this. For the most part, Africans are very, very respectful. They're also very, very calm. We don't speak so highly. We are not as expressive. We are not as open. open because it's just within our culture. In our culture, you have to be humble, you have to be respectful, you don't talk too highly on a tone. Most African cultures are like that. So that will play a lot in how people talk to you and how people respond to you. Sometimes people won't even speak things straightforward. Why? Because being blunt or being very open-minded or saying things the way it is can come off as very, very rude in most African cultures. Even when it comes to dressing up, we, in general, we do dress in a more decent or modest way, I should say. Like, we do cover a lot. Whereas I know when people come to Africa, they want to enjoy the sun, you know, so they want to wear, you know, their nice summer clothes. It is okay, you can wear this, but be aware that when you wear these kind of clothes, then you're going to get the stare because people are going to look at you like, ooh, okay. Okay, this is a foreigner, you know, okay, this is a foreigner, that's why they're dressed like this. So it's not that serious, guys. So as long as you're respectful to everyone, you just nice, say hello, smile, and go on with your business. So yeah, those are my 5 top tips or things that you should know and you should do before you come to Africa. So I do have a bonus tip, and that is buy insurance if you can, travel health insurance, so that in case anything happens to you, it's better to be prepared, you know, than to be unprepared, you know. Maybe lose your luggage, you know, that can happen, or even fall ill, that can happen. Anything could happen, and this is life, you know, so it is good that you may need to have a travel health insurance. That is my bonus tip. So let me know what you think of my must do things before you travel to Africa. If you've been to Africa and have traveled around, make sure that you do share your experience in the comment section. What was your favorite country? What was your strange thing that you saw about Africa? Like, ooh, okay. Share your thoughts in the comment section and let me know what you think. And of course, also put more tips in the comment section so that whoever is coming to watch this video, they're also going to learn more as well. I am also organizing a business trip for people who want to relocate to Uganda or visit Uganda or even start a business in Uganda. It's completely a business. You're going to be touring real estate, land, properties, and all the good stuff, learning about the business environment in Uganda. So if you'd like to learn more, there is a link in the description to the website, or even if you just click in the banner, there is a link to the website. Send me an email, reach out, I'll give you all the details. It is scheduled for 23rd October up to 1st November. So I'm really excited. If that sounds interesting to you, then make sure that you do reach out to me. And I do have a merch shop. If you'd like support as well, there is a link in the description. And that's it for today, guys. Like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you on the next video.